Welcome back, everybody. This is Giraffe Dragon here, bringing you another episode of Paper Mario: The Thousand Year Door. Last time we made more progress in the pit and the Glitz Pit. This time we're gonna be finishing up the chapter here. Well, boy, howdy, Gonzalez, fixing for a fight, huh? Well, alrighty then. Let me just see. Your next opponent will be ranked one in the Glitz Pit, the Koopinator. Now listen, I want you to avoid using the special moves. That's actually kind of funny, because in my practice recording earlier today, I was asked to do exactly that, to use a special move, which was a little unusual, as I hadn't seen that happen before. And yeah, that should just about... Wait a second. I'm an idiot. I almost screwed myself there. Okay, guys, we're ready. And we're gonna swap to Goombella. Now, in terms of some interesting details about this, well, I'll save that for just a sec. For when we're in the title box, as per usual. And I'm sorry if that seems like as if it sort of slows the pace down. I just remembered that they have, like, different names depending on which place that the game comes from. And I always found that so interesting. For our next battle, we got the merciless executioner, the Great Gonzalez, and the Razor Blade Brigade. Yep, a fight to the finish with the Koopinator. We aren't gonna lose to scrubs like you. You, finally, I get a piece of you. Finally, we'll see who's truly stronger. Get yourselves ready to battle. Now in terms of as to what's special about him. Give me just a sec. He's known as this is a Dark Koopa Troll. But enough about as to what he is in just a second. Let's go over who he is. In Spanish, he's known as a La Toreadora, or the Crusher. In French, he's known as a Koopa Elite, which is a portmanteau of Koopa Troopa and Elite. In Germany, he's known as a As Koopa Trio, or Ace Koopa Troll, which is the actual name of Dark Koopa Trolls in Japan. And in Italian, he's called E Koopa Matro. In fact, his name is a Koopa Marto Joe. And basically, his name just translates to the Koopa Troll. The Koopa Troll. Anyways, these guys just totally ooze toughness, don't you think? HP 25, attack 5, defense 2. After charges of power, its next attack will be devastating. Try to survive it. It's almost like those red eyes are just there to warn you just how tough it is. Or maybe it doesn't get much sleep. We could believe either at this point. Now, basically, what you want to do is that if you have the Quake Badge, go ahead and just use that now. And he acts just like a regular Koopa. He doesn't even act like a shady Koopa, he just acts like a standard Koopa, which I suppose is a good thing in this case, because let's face it, this guy would be way harder if he was set up like a shady Koopa. Imagine trying to do that. And now I see as to why Rock Hard thought he was such a chump. He's difficult if you fight him straight, but if you fight him like this, he's an absolute joke. Because all you gotta do is just knock him over. And okay, thank goodness. Thank goodness mushrooms are racist. Anyways, we didn't use up any star points, so we're gonna be able to get on to our next fight, too. We're just blazing. We got ourselves a winner, the Great Gonzalez! Ha ha ha! How'd that floor taste? Here's your fight money, Mr. Gonzalez. You received 15 coins. Mario's rank rose to 1. Now, if you'll excuse me, I must be going. There we go. Ding, ding, ding. Mail call! You think it's from our pal or the guy who hates us? Remove the Great Gonzalez posters in the lobby from X. This guy sounds like a nut, but hey, he's all we got. What's he want us to do again? Peel off your posters in the lobby? Sounds good to me. I hated your... You're not a very photogenic person, Mario. Anyways, we'll meet you there in just a sec. Okay, guys, we're back. And if you're curious as to which one you have to peel down, it's always the same one. It's this one right here. And let's see, whatever could that key be for? Go to the second floor of the storage room. And then I figure I might as well just go ahead and do this, make it symmetrical. And we'll meet you in the storage room. Cut. Okay, guys, we're back. And we received a storage key. And there's only one locked door left. This one. Huh. So let's see what's in here. Got a whole bunch of boxes. And a breakable brick. Might as well hit this down. What? Red herring? Oh, wait, I'm sorry. Whoa! You gotta be kidding me! Bandy Andy and King K! Let's go ahead and talk to them. Or try to, like, tell them. Poor King K, what happened here? Bandy Andy looks terrible. Who could have done this? We know that it has to have been someone superior, but it must have been someone really powerful. Gonzalez, listen to me. Man, don't get near the light when no one is around. Ugh. Come on, shake it off, buddy. What do you mean don't go near the ring? I don't think I'm gonna make it. Ugh. Gonzalez, did you see that? That was Jolene. This is craziness. What is going on here? I don't know, but we don't know anything. All we know is that Jolene keeps popping up after we complete one of X's tasks. It's almost as if she's spying on us. Let's remember that from later. And, oh boy. And, cut real quick. Okay, guys, we're back. We're gonna reserve a match. Rick Gonzalez, how did he fix it for a fun, huh? Yeah. Well, guess what? Your next match is the title match! Hooey! Don Tootin! You're up against the champ, Rockhawk! Now, I want to see a fair and exciting match, so don't you let me down now, you hear? Now, listen, son. In this battle, I want you to use at least one special move. The crowd needs something flashy. Catch my drift? Give them a good show. Now, get in there and blow the roof off, son. And, basically, yeah, that's always set. What's it like knowing you're so close to the top, huh? Don't get a big head, baby. You know, I'm actually a little jealous of your hair. I mean your skill. But forget skill. I'm gonna try harder than you and become champ anyway. It's my boy! Oh. Piss off. It's my boy! Izuku Midoriya! I just imagine thinking that. You fight on, Mr. Gonzalez. I'm gonna keep fighting too. You, should you ever face me again, you will know the pain of utter defeat. I just like to imagine that he was humiliated being bested so easily by just a well-thought-out strategy. Also, something's off here. Hey, where do you think you're going, pal, huh? The ring's this way. Yeah, you go this way this time because it's a special match. I mean, this is basically just like sports entertainment. I mean, I guess this kind of works. Slow down, will you, buddy? Why are we going this weird way again? He doesn't even answer us this time. Something's up. We missed the door. Oi! Beep, beep! We need to turn around, buddy! Oh, no. Why do I get the feeling we're just gonna be trapped in here? This is a minor league locker room. And speaking of which, where is everybody? I know he said to wait here, but Mario, we're gonna miss our fight against the champ. Now for today's main event, the top dog in the major league, the great Gonzalez, is finally gonna throw down with the champ, the one, the only, Rockhawk. First one into the ring, the Pharaoh Nuclear. Reactor Rockhawk! You go, champ! Rockin'! I don't even know what that guy in the bottom says, because I never got the chance to see it. Ooh, doggies, champ! How you feeling, son? The challenge is a handful!
You don't want a handful of this! There's only one champ, and it's me! Even if this Gonzalez Wolf ever shows up, what's he gonna do, huh? Nothing!
But the Green Gonzales made it to the top of the majors faster than anyone ever. He even got up there faster than you did, Chip. What do you got to say about that?
What do I have to say? That's why. Who cares what this guy did to a bunch of shots? Because now he gets rocked.
Okay, they are like totally ridiculously lino. I'm gonna find out what's up. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, Mario, it's locked. The door's locked. We're totally trapped. Now I'm just imagining Brock Hawk sitting in a computer chair with a potato chip in his mouth saying, Kikakudori.
And now for our challenger, the merciless executioner, the Grey Gonzales.
Hold the phone, folks. What's the heck going on? What happened to the Grey Gonzales?
I'll tell you what's happened. He fears the Rock.
Hooey, what a stupefying development, folks. Did the Rick Gonzales really turn yellow and head for the hills like a dog? I tell you what, folks, if he don't show up soon, he's gonna forfeit the match. Mario, if we don't do something soon, we're gonna forfeit that match. We gotta get out of here. Honestly, something I'm a little disappointed by is the fact... By the way, you're only ever gonna be in these rooms once, so if you wanna tattle these rooms, you guys can go right ahead. But something I'm a bit disappointed in is the fact that... There is nobody in these rooms. Because I would've thought that for a heel, like, maneuver... You would have everyone that you have fought previously fight you again. Or at least, like, they would be in the rooms. They go like, you know, chump, what are you doing in here? And also, this is the only time you'll get access to the toilet. Funnily enough, because the one in your Major League locker room is always occupied. And I don't know why. By the way, each character has something different to say, and you can do this as many times as you want. At least until you exit this door. That was maybe the grossest thing I've ever done. But let's get to the fight. Yeah, because the second you... It says occupied. Whoa, what's the deal, man? You drop your hammer on the kid? I hate doing that. I love that. And he brings that up. What, Gonzales, huh? Don't you have a rash right now, maybe? Like, everyone's so confused as to how we got here. You, Gonzales, why do you dally here? Your foe awaits. Why did you just come out of the toilet? I was the only one that actually bothers to ask that. And let's talk to this chump here.
You're late, Mr. Gonzales. You better get in there. The crowd's going berserk. Would you just call me? How dare you say that? I did not trick you. I have no idea what you're talking about, but you better check yourself.
I imagine that he was either beaten into submission by Rock Hawk, which is unlikely. Which, I'm not honestly sure. Nader was probably bribed.
The moment you've been waiting for, folks, the Great Gonzales just entered the arena.
Gonzales, Gonzales, Gonzales. Wow, looks like we actually made it. And listen to those cheers, Mario. They love you. Come on, let's go put this oversized rooster in his place, huh? By the way, in case you're curious, you don't actually have to worry about forfeiting the match. You won't forfeit this. It's not possible to forfeit the match. You can't be late.
Will his hammer hurt and harm be enough to rock the Rock Hawk socks? Now at long last, the battle to end all battles is here. Let's keep it clean, boys.
Oh yeah, let's do this. Okay, Mario, this is it. A match with a champ. Let's destroy this guy.
You wimp should have stayed locked up, safe and sound.
What? What are you saying? Don't tell me it was you who got that security guard to lock us up.
You're darn right I did. I also sent you that poison cake, suckers. That's what happened when you mess with me, baby. You'll meet the pain train.
So you're the jerk who's been sending us mean emails about the Crystal Star.
Huh? I have no idea what you're babbling about. What's a Crystal Star? No way. I don't care. I may not play exactly fair, but I got skills, Pucks. And now you're about to meet them all, baby. Prepare to be rocked!
kind of threw my voice out a little bit. Anyways, go ahead and tattle Rock Hawk. And in case you're curious, this is the only rematchable boss fight in the entire game. That's Rock Hawk. He flips, flaps, and slaps. That's what the book says. I didn't make this up. HP 40, attack 3, defense 1. He's really good at aerial maneuvers, but other than that, he's pretty meh. One thing you should know is that Rock Hawk never fights above the board. Kansas is at least a lifelessness, you know? And basically, that's the end of the dialogue for that, and I might as well go ahead and go over as to what Rock Hawk's other names were. In the Spanish version of the game, Rock Hawk is called Hawk Hogan, referencing Hulk Hogan. Also in the Spanish version, after Rock Hawk beats Koopinator at the start of the chapter, he states, "You should go back to playing Super Smash Bros. Melee." This was probably taken out due to the fact that majority of Super Smash Bros. Professional players come from the United States. Then it was like one of Nintendo's like top IPs or something. In the Japanese and French versions, he is called Gold Hawk, while in the Italian version, he is referred to as Goldie. So that's really about it. He's designed to be a heels character, and he also has a lot of moves based on Luchadori type of stuff, as well as like a Macho Man Randy Savage sort of personality. Go ahead and just swap him belly to Jack. Charge. You see what I mean? Okay. To make him a little bit more manageable, shell his ass. Gone. He's very susceptible to this. I don't know what the exact percentage is, but as far as I'm aware, it's a 100% chance. Oh no. Fog.
Not too shabby, you better. And I thought this may actually be fun. Don't get your head swelled though, cause you got a ways to go. Check this out. Time to rock!
He missed. In the original in my previous recording of this, I ended up super guarding it. I'm guessing that's a very inaccurate move. That's what I have to guess. Okay, time to finish this out.
Earth Tremor!
Okay, time to focus. Bum, 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 bum. Got it! I was a little scared there.
No!
Sadly, we didn't get to see his move where he actually goes around the side, around the top of the board, and he sort of hangs off the ceiling.
I, Rock Hawk, the champ, the undefeated master, lost to such losers.
Huh, something's off. He only gave us around 10 star points. Bosses are supposed to give us 30. That's a bit odd. Folks, I feel like my eyes just popped out of my head! We got ourselves a miracle! Technique versus technique, raw power versus raw power, a clash of superhumans! Folks, this was honestly, without question, no doubt, absolutely the most legendary, amazing, and probable history maker battle of all time! And the victor of this match for the ages was...
the Grey Gonzalez!
Congratulations, Gonzalez, you're the champion, son!
Give him a hand, folks! The new Glimpspit champ, the Grey Gonzalez!
I am so sorry, guys. I kind of threw my voice out a little. It's just, I like getting into the voice of Grubbit. It's so much fun. Okay. Well, you finally did it, son. Today's your first day as the new champ. Here's your belt. Tell you what, I'm gonna go ahead and get you set up in the champ's room right away. Miss Jolene, be a peach and show Gonzalez here the champion's room, okay? Absolutely, sir. Well then, Mr. Champion, would you follow me, please? Crowd's still cheering, huh? There must be absolutely rabid out there. In fact, if you decide to go out into the lobby, you'll be sworn by fans. Congratulations again, Mr. Champion. From now on, this is where you'll stay. It's your room now, so make yourself at home. You will use the terminal as you always have, of course. Will there be anything else? Well then, have a nice day, Mr. Champion. Yeah! We finally made it, Gonzalez, but... You know, Rockhawk really sounded close about the Crystal Star. Sounded about as dumb as a chicken nugget. We still don't have any leads on that thing, I mean. What the heck could it be? Oh, sorry, where the heck could it be? Hang on, Gonzalez. You hear that? A voice is coming from somewhere. You think it's a ghost? you have to set that thing turned up? That scared me silly! Find the ghost in the chance room, from X. There's actually a ghost in here? Okay, that is not cool. Ghosts are scary. And if you notice right there, that poster there is a Mario. And I wonder, did he have that installed, like, just in case? Because the angle of the room when you come in, it's this. You never actually see it from this angle. So for all we know, it's the exact same regardless. Anyways, basically all you gotta do here is just hover over here. There we go. We're in the air duct, right? Where does it lead? Yeah. Well, that's in perfect condition as usual. Yep, as long as I got that baby working for me, this old bot ain't never gonna get weak. But I'm gonna have to watch my tootsies here for a little bit. First I let that King K idiot walk in on me when I was with that porn. And now I can't shake the feeling that Jolene and Gonzalez are on to me. They know my kinks. Well, I guess I'll burn that bridge when the time comes. I'll just disappear them. Yep, just like I did to the others. Like I did to Prince Mush, the first champ. That voice, it's Rubber. So he's behind all those missing fires. I better lock this room up tighter than a peanut butter jar at a squirrel convention. And I'll just go ahead and hide that paper relating to that in the desk drawer. There we go. You know what, though? Since I'm thinking aloud here, good fighters ain't nothing to mess with. Even Rockhawk lost to Gonzalez. This new champ might have to disappear pretty soon, for my sake. I think he's gone. Let's check that desk drawer of his. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. I meant to go down. Okay, you get a star piece there, and then you want to get this star piece here. And by the way, you can technically come back to this room at a later point in time in case you miss these two. Whoa, bingo! I bet it's that paper old Grubba hid. Check it out, Mario! Yeah, a machine under the ring using the Crystal Star? These are the blueprints! I don't know what the rest of this nerd talk says, but I think the Crystal Star powers it. This paper's right, then the machine can suck the power out of people. Yuck! Oh, crud. You think that King K and Benny and he got all drained or something? Great Galloping Gulpits! How in tarnation did you get in here, son? Well, slam me and call me Sassafras! You're staring at my secret paper, too! Shut up! You make me sick! Why'd you drain King K and Benny and he, huh? Whoa, Nelly, this ain't good! After him! Come back here, coward! I thought I pressed left on the D-pad so I could access my partners. Mr. Grubby, he just ran by at about Mach 6, I think. He went to the ring. I'm just curious what everyone else says. He just says the same thing. Mr. Rubber, yeah, he was wiggling. We were told not to go to the rings at night, when no one was around. No one's here, nothing to be broadcasted. Strange lights. I gotta say, y'all are a couple slack-jawed idiots sniffing around my business. Now you know my big secret. I'm afraid you're gonna have to take a little old dirt nap. Remember when he said that there's something in the upstairs that no one would care missing? He was talking about Bandy Annie and King K. He cares for no one but himself. Look, Mario, up there, the real crystal star. Yuck, 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 yuck. How you like my machine? Pretty damn nice, huh? Yep, I've been sucking power from fires with this baby. You're dying tootin', and you know why? Cause it keeps my body forever young, son! Using a crystal star to look good? You're so totally vain. You're gonna pay for that. Oh, just shut your traps now. I'll use my crystal star however I can, please. Check this out. Muscle up! Insert Super Saiyan music here. Macho Grubba! Whoa, Grubba got huge! That's what she said. Hooey, I'm gonna smoosh you guys into guacamole and snack and your energy too! Oh, the beats! I need the beats! Macho! I'm a powerhouse now, you pesky little pieces of Ferrari piffle! So long as I got this here machine, my bottle'll be rough, tough, and ultra buff! Okay, Mario, I had about enough of this guy's yapping. Let's take him down. I'll take that. Okay. Now, for some names that he has in this game. In Japanese, he's known as Machito Gunsu, or Macho Guns because Guns was his Japanese name. Spanish, he was called Leonardo de Tansco. Leonardo Dantes is a famous TV celebrity in Spain. De Tansco, however, means horrific in Spanish. It might also be a word of the Spanish word for gigantic. In French, he is called Stero Gangs. Stero is a diminutive of steroids, and Gangs is Grubba's French name. In German, he's known as Mega Klobone, or Mega Grubba. That's Macho Grubba. He's Grubba all souped up on a crystal star power. HP 60, attack is 4, defense 0. His attack pattern is simple. We're gonna blur that part out. When he powers himself up with all sorts of crazy power-up moves, so it's pretty important to pay close attention to how he powered himself up. The craziest thing about this muscle head is that he used to be that chubby Grubba. I guess the crystal stars really are powerful. This is an example of what happens when power goes to the wrong people. And watch what he does turn one. Watch what he does. He can double his attack. Not by double his power, he can increase his number of turns. This is the only occasion outside of one other case where you'll ever see this in the game. To make him a bit more manageable, though, I suggest using this move here. It makes him very manageable. Okay, so look, he can do anything. He can up his attack, defense, charge. You see, he just did his defense there. I think it's a good idea to use this, because I think this is a piercing move. Yeah, it is. He is very dangerous, and just so you know, he is susceptible to... Oh no. Ugh. Now, that might not seem like a whole lot. He just got weak. We weakened him with Mini Egg. Imagine how much damage that would have done, and imagine if that was used on Mario. That would have insta-killed me. You know, minding the three or so, like, mushrooms I have in my pocket. He does a lot of crazy attacks.
Oh yeah, keep it spicy! You know I love a good tussle, Gonzalez! Keep on scrapping, son, because it ain't gonna do you much good in the end!
This is just such a tough fight. Well, it really can be, because first time I played this game, I had a very hard time with it. Not a good indicator, I know.
Yarr!
And by the way, if he gets to low enough health, around 10 or less, he actually starts panting, which sort of shows that, you know, he's only one of two bosses that actually shows that he's getting, like, you know, closer and closer to losing.
No! How'd this happen? How could a perfect blonde like mine lose to such a chub? Oh, great Gonzalez. Great fight there, son. Great fight.
He has a lot of other dialogue, and I'll probably put his Wikipedia page in the description.
Ugh.
Mr. Champion. Also, something else I want to mention about Grubba is that he has a couple other moves. He can do a backflip, which he considered to be an illegal move. No, I mean Mario. Please allow me to offer my earnest thanks for defeating that foul Grubba. Jolene! I really have to apologize. I'm so sorry that I had to get you involved. But you must understand, I had to learn the truth about this arena by any means. Let me tell you everything. I had a little brother once by the name of Mush. He'd have done anything for me. Our family was always poor, so he became a fighter here to support all of us. But he suddenly went missing one day. Our family was inconsolable. I suspected foul play, so I got hired on as the manager and investigated in secret. As I looked for clues about my brother, I accidentally saw Mr. Grubba transform. Seeing what I was up against, I almost gave up hope. And then you appeared. So I decided to secretly guide you. Aha, so our ex-buddy was... Strange, I was half expecting to see an old man wearing sunglasses and a duck trench coat. Correct, it was me. Once I saw you fight, I knew you were the only one who could challenge Grubba. Now, sir.
No, not sir, Grubba. I want answers right now. What did you do with my precious little brother? You know exactly what I'm talking about. The first champion, Prince Mush.
Ugh, Prince Mush, he discovered the secret of my power-sucking machine. I had him, disappear. Any which way you look at it, he ain't around these parts no more.
No!
I suspected as much. Oh, poor sweet Mush. Boy, I thought she was kind of mean, but turns out she was just worried for her brother. By the way, check out...
This is bullshit!
I'm sorry, my French?
Whoa, is this... Am I back in the glitch pit? Mush!
Oh, is that really you, sis? What are you doing here?
I was just...
There, Mush. It's okay. It's all over, finally.
Is that what crystal stars can do?
Basically, Deus Ex Machina anything, basically. Now, Mario, the crystal star is yours. This is a really touching moment. And I hate to ruin it. It's just... I honestly wish... that I just wish that I know this sounds a bit wrong, but I kind of wish that Mush didn't come back. And I'll explain my reasoning in just a second. We can now use Power Lift, which is very, very useful. It becomes like my go-to boss turn one move, essentially, most of the time. Pluswell's seeming underside was a dark, dangerous place seething with conspiracy. With the help of the lovely Miss Jolene, Marty revealed Rubba's true identity, and acquired the third crystal star by defeating that monstrous Macho Rubba. Rubba has used the power of the crystal star to run his power drain machine. What other hidden powers might the strange mystical items possess? Now, I'm actually just gonna go ahead and just turn it off here. But I want to continue talking to you guys for a minute. Because for one thing, I kind of wish that Prince Mush didn't come back. I know that's a little strange to say that, but I think that the story of the impact of the crystal stars, their capabilities, and what happens if they're used in the wrong hands could have been utilized so much better if it was done that way. Now, I understand, this game was given an E10 plus rating, so that means that it was meant for people around the age of 10 or older. I get that. But it was something that I kind of wished, and that was just because it would have worked so well in a narrative standpoint, and it would have helped give us more of a reason to continue fighting to gain more crystal stars. Not only for just what Grubba done, but for the fact that the powers of the crystal star are almost insurmountable to everything else. Anyways, this is my personal little rant is over. You guys have a great night, and I will see you next time with the Bowser and Peach sections. See you all then.